Today I'm presenting a case of a 60-year-old man who presented with chest pain. He presented in 2016 with quite a non-cardiac sounding chest pain. He is a non-smoker with no diabetes. He has well-controlled hypertension. His father had a myocardial infarction at 65, and he was a non-smoker. So this was quite a big shock for the family, and he has been quite concerned about this part of the family history. He has a BMI of 26, blood pressure 130, over 70 millimeter mercury. His exam was unremarkable, cholesterol 4.6 and LDL 3.4, which is 131 milligram per deciliter. He is on telmisartan 40 milligram daily. To investigate his chest pain, he does a stress echocardiogram. He exercises for 9.5 minutes, achieving 11 METs. This is a very good exercise tolerance, very reassuring. There was absolutely no chest pain or limiting dyspnea. There was no ischemic features. There were no ischemic features on ECG or echocardiogram. So based on these results, we could tell him your pain is not cardiac in origin. He asks a question. He says, I don't want to end up like my father, having a heart attack at the age of 65. Is this test enough to tell me my risk is low or high or where I stand? And of course, the answer is no. We tell him stress echocardiogram here was only done to tell you your pain is from your heart or not, and that's it. To calculate your risk, we can use a risk calculator. We plug his numbers into a calculator. As you can see, age, blood pressure, and all the other elements, and the calculator comes up with 11% risk, which is intermediately elevated. An optimal risk for this person would have been 5.7%. But we know that we have got another very important test, which is calcium score, which can modify this risk quite significantly. So he is sent to do a coronary calcium score. His coronary calcium score comes back at 595, which is significantly elevated. Now we recalculate his risk, incorporating the calcium score. We use a different calculator, MISA calculator, which has a coronary artery calcification as part of it. Now we can see that his risk is 20% and not 11%. He is now high risk. We have reclassified him based on the results of coronary calcium score. So now he knows that his risk is high. He starts aspirin, he accepts statin, he changes his diet, and starts a very vigorous regular exercise program. 1 year later, he presented to emergency department with a very atypical chest pain again. He ended up having a CT coronary angiogram, which showed a calcium score of 650. And moderate mid-LAD and RCA disease. Of course, his troponin and ECG were negative. He had another stress test. He did exercise for 10 minutes on Bruce protocol. No ECG or echo evidence of ischemia. His LDL is 1.5 millimole per liter. Again, he was reassured that his pain is not cardiac in origin and encouraged to continue his medications and diet as well as exercise. 1 year later, in 2018, he returns for review. At this time, his LDL is excellent at 1.4 millimole per liter. His blood pressure excellent. He walks about 15,000 steps per day with no chest pain. He has lost about 8 kilograms by diet and exercise in 2 years. And basically, he's doing very well. But he asks another question. He says, can I repeat my calcium score to see what's happening and where I stand? Evidence is provided to him that he really doesn't need to repeat the calcium score. We know he is high risk and he should just take his medications and continue the good work. Regardless, He wants to do a scan and he pays for it, and he does another calcium score, which comes back at 760. We see that initially it was 590. He comes back quite anxious and stressed with few questions. First, he wants to know more about coronary calcium score. What is coronary calcium score and why we did it? Calcium score only stratifies or reclassifies someone's future risk of CAD, and that someone, this is the most important part, that someone should have low to intermediate risk, like our patient, which had a risk of 11%, which is intermediate risk. So this person with low to intermediate risk, if they have high calcium score, they are reclassified to high risk. And by being reclassified to high risk, their medical therapy should be intensified. They accept medication much easier, and they become more determined to change their diet and start physical activity. Basically, patient awareness rises, and that awareness will make accepting change quite easier. So here, the most important part is that you do not do a calcium score in a high-risk patient. The patients should be low to intermediate risk. I will try to explain with a different case as why you don't do a calcium score in a high-risk patient. Just for a moment, forget about the original patient. I'm just showing and presenting a very quick case as why we do not do calcium score in high-risk patients. So this is a 56-year-old man with well-controlled type 2 diabetes for about 20 years. He does not smoke nor has hypertension, but he has got a very significant family history. One brother at 52 with bypass, one brother fatal myocardial infarction at 58, and father fatal myocardial infarction at 67. All of them were non-smokers. He is not on statin, and why? Someone actually told him that, hey, your cholesterol is borderline, let's do a calcium score, and if it is zero, you don't really need a statin. And that's why he's not on a statin. For some reason, he ended up having a CT coronary angiogram. The reason, that's beside the point, that why he has CT coronary angiogram, but let's have a look at his coronary arteries. These are his coronary arteries, RCA, LCX, and LAD. We can see that there is absolutely no calcium in these arteries, so his calcium score is zero, but let's concentrate on his LAD for a moment. Let's concentrate here on LAD. If I zoom on this section, we can see that we have got two big plaques on this side of the artery wall, these areas. These are soft plaques, means there is no calcium in them. They have got a lipid core, so it's full of lipid and foam cells. These are high-risk plaques. They are angry, and they have got a thin fibrous cap, which is vulnerable to rupture, causing acute myocardial infarction and blockage of the artery. So you can see that there is no calcium in them. So the calcium score becomes back at zero. And this is quite misleading. And a calcium score of zero deprives this person from a life-saving therapy, which is a statin, which is plaque-modifying agent. Let's go back to our original case, which was the 60-year-old man with intermediate risk and high calcium score. His first question was that he wanted to know about calcium score and why it was done. His next question is that, do I need an invasive coronary angiogram? At the end of the day, my calcium score is high. It's very important to know that calcium score should not be used as a guide to decide about coronary intervention. Basically, when calcium score testing was started about 20 years ago, many cases were sent for coronary intervention or angioplasty based on high calcium scores. And that's why after a while, For many years, this test was not being used till around 2010. The reason is that we do coronary calcium score in people who have no symptoms, or someone who we have proved based on a functional test that the chest pain is not cardiac in origin. And if you are that person, you don't need coronary angiogram or angioplasty. So no matter what your calcium score is, a calcium score should not be used as a guide for coronary angiogram or angioplasty. It just means that the risk is high. And his next question and last one is that, should I stop my statin? It seems that it's not working and my calcium score is rising, and let's see why. It is proven that statins promote vascular calcification. In one study in 2015, they reported an annual calcium score increase of about 30% at the age of 50 and 21% at the age of 70 when they started statin therapy. Again, another study in 2015 showed two mechanisms as how the statins work. They showed that number one, statins reduce the plaque volume. So basically they shrink the plaque, they make it a bit smaller and denser. And number two, which is the more important one, they change the composition of the plaque. So they suck the lipid core out and replace it by fibrous tissue plus calcium. Hence, the calcium score goes up after starting statin therapy. So imagine you have got an artery. In this artery, you have got a plaque. This plaque has got a lipid core, which is soft, and a thin fibrous cap. This is a soft plaque and very vulnerable to rupture, causing myocardial infarction. When you start statin therapy, what happens? So number one, the plaque becomes a bit smaller, you can see there, so volume reduction. And number two, the composition has changed. Now the lipid core is nearly gone and you have got fibrous tissue and calcium. This is a calcified and a stable plaque. That's why statins are called plaque-modifying treatments. Plaque-modifying treatments. So from a plaque which looked like this, soft and angry with a lipid core, we change it to a plaque which looks like this. You have got calcium and is stable, and this plaque can stay there for many years without causing any problem. So although calcium score is a very good test, repeating calcium score after starting a statin therapy can only cause anxiety, confusion, without adding any useful information, and it is not recommended. To recap the main points of the presentation, calcium score is done only and only to stratify someone's future risk if they are low to intermediate risk and not high risk. Calcium score should not be used to decide about coronary intervention or angiogram. Calcium does not equal plaque. Plaques can either be calcified or non-calcified, and like in our example, if you have non-calcified plaques, your calcium score can be zero, but you can be very high risk. And the last point, repeating a positive calcium score is not recommended, and it can cause anxiety, confusion without any useful information. Thank you very much for your attention. I hope you have enjoyed the presentation. Please like and subscribe, and hope to see you for the next presentation.